What's up, it's Richie here with Statifying Football. This is week 6 of the college football season. These are my prime time games, the games that start at 7:30 or later. Michigan and Nebraska. Starting Michigan, they beat Wisconsin 38-17. Cade McNamara, 197 passing, 2 touchdowns defensively. They had 6 sacks and forced 3 turnovers in that game. Nebraska, they destroyed Northwestern 56-7. Adrian Martinez, 202 passing and a touchdown, plus 50 rushing yards and 3 touchdowns. Jaquez Gant ran for 127. Samori Torrey, 2 catches, 108 yards and a touchdown. They had 657 yards of offense against Northwestern, and defensively at 4 sacks. This is what Nebraska should look like under Scott Frost, the head coach, with Adrian Martinez running that offense anyway. If Nebraska can do this, they can beat Michigan. They've been way too inconsistent, though. I think Michigan is a really, really strong team and possibly could win the Big Ten this year. So I'm going to go Michigan winning that one. All right, Notre Dame and Virginia Tech. Notre Dame, they lost to Cincinnati 24-13. Jack Cohn wasn't very effective. He passed for 114 and an interception. He got pulled. Drew Pine almost brought them back. He passed for 143 and a touchdown. They turned over 3 times in that loss to Cincinnati. Virginia Tech coming off a bye a couple of weeks ago. They had a close win against 1AA Richmond, 21-10. Now, Richmond is a good FCS team, but still, they kind of struggled there. Braxton Burmeister passed for 212, a touchdown, ran for 35. Trey Turner, 6 catches, 102, and a touchdown, and they had a punt return for a touchdown there. I do think Notre Dame is overrated. I think they probably lose a couple of games, and possibly they could lose this. Virginia Tech, neither team is way better than the other. Notre Dame is only picked by 1 point to win. Virginia Tech has a strong defense, but I think the difference is, I think offense for Notre Dame is a little bit slightly better than Virginia Tech. So I'm going to go Notre Dame with a slight win there, but they're on big, big upset alert in this game. All right, LSU and Kentucky. LSU, they lost a heartbreaker to Auburn 24-19. Max Johnson, 325 passing, a touchdown, a pick. Keyshawn Boutte, 6 catches, 127, and a touchdown there. They only ran for 1 yard. They got it. 11 yards, whatever. They got to get that running game going. Kentucky had a big upset win against Florida, 20-13. Will Levis sucked, though, 7-17, 87 yards, a touchdown, a pick. It was really their special teams. They had a blocked field goal return for a touchdown and forced Florida into 15 penalties. Kentucky is not the number 16 team in the country. I know I sound bitter. They're 5-0. Look at their next 4 games. They're going to lose all of them, including this one to LSU. All right, Alabama and Texas A&M. Alabama did whatever they wanted. I was totally wrong about this game. I thought Ole Miss was going to beat Alabama. And Alabama and Georgia look like they wanted the top 2 teams in the country, and then it's everybody else this year. Bama won 42-21. Bryce Young, 241, 2 touchdowns and a pick. Brian Robinson ran all over them for 171 yards and 4 rushing touchdowns. Texas A&M is exactly who I thought they were. They are very mediocre. They lost 2 games already. They may very well lose 5 or 6 this season. They lost to Mississippi State 26-22. Zach Calzada, 135, a touchdown, a pick. Isaiah Spiller ran for 100. I don't think this is close. Alabama wins huge. All right, Georgia State and Louisiana Monroe. Georgia State lost 45-16 to Appalachian State. Cornelius Brown, 171 passing, 2 interceptions. Darren Ranger, 75 passing yards, a touchdown, a pick. They turned over 3 times in that game. ULM got destroyed by Coastal Carolina, 59-6. Chandler Rogers, 100 passing yards, plus 40 rushing yards. Georgia State and ULM lost to the 2 best teams maybe in the Sun Belt, in Appalachian State and Coastal Carolina. I think Georgia State has a little too much offense, though, going, and I think they beat ULM. All right, Utah and USC, pretty big game in the Pac-12. Utah coming off a bye. Their last game was a couple of weeks ago against Washington State, 24-13 victory for Utah. Cam Rising, 137 passing, 32 rushing yards. TJ Pledger ran for 117 and a touchdown. They've turned over 3 times. They can't do that against USC. Defensively, though, they had 8 sacks. Van Fillinger had 3 sacks. They had 3 turnovers and had an interception return for a touchdown. That defense may be able to get after that passing game of USC. USC had a nice win against Colorado, 37-14. Keaton Slovis, 276 passing, 3 touchdown passes. Keyontae Ingram ran for 124. Drake London may be the best receiver in the country. 9 catches, 130 yards, and a touchdown. Defensively, they had 5 sacks themselves. I think this will be a pretty close game. Normally, I go with I might go with Utah because of their defense, but I think USC's offense may be a little bit too much for Utah's offense to keep up with. So I'm going to USC to win that one. All right, Memphis and Tulsa, possibly high-scoring game. Memphis, they got upset by Temple, 34-31. Seth Hennigan, 305 passing and 3 touchdowns. Calvin Austin, 8 catches, 104 yards. Tulsa got destroyed by Houston, 45-10. Davis Brin, 258 passing, 1 touchdown through 3 interceptions. Sam Crawford, 5 catches, 101 in that game. I think Memphis bounces back. I think Memphis wins pretty big. They may not destroy him like Houston because Memphis has been kind of shaky this year in terms as a team, but I do think Memphis wins. Tulsa's favorite with 3.5. I don't understand how Tulsa's favorite. They were favored against Houston and they're 1-4. I think Memphis wins and wins still kind of convincingly. All right, New Mexico and San Diego State. New Mexico, they got destroyed by Air Force, 38-10. Terry Wilson, 179 passing, a touchdown, an interception. They only had 226 total yards and turned it over 3 times in that game. San Diego State, they're coming off a bye. A couple weeks ago, they beat Towson, 48-21. Lucas Johnson, 149 passing, 1 touchdown, 1 interception. They ran for 281 yards. They put up 450 yards of offense. They had a blocked punt return for a touchdown. I think San Diego State may be one of the best teams in the Mountain West, and I think they should take care of business against New Mexico. Our UCLA and Arizona. UCLA, they lost 42-23 to Arizona State. Dorian Thompson-Robinson, 235 passing, 1 touchdown, plus 96 rushing yards. Greg Dulcich, 9 catches, 136 yards there. Arizona coming off a bye a couple of weeks ago. They lost to Oregon 41-19, but it was only 24-19 halfway through the fourth quarter. Jordan McLeod, though, 233 passing, 1 touchdown. He threw 5 interceptions in that game, ran for 64 yards. Defensively, they forced a safety. I think UCLA bounces back. I think they win huge and destroys Arizona. And then the final game of the night is New Mexico State and Nevada. New Mexico State kept it close against San Jose State. I think I picked New Mexico State for that win. They only lost 37-31. Jonah Johnson passed for 300 yards, 3 touchdowns, 1 interception, ran for 24 yards himself. So they could keep up with Nevada with that Nevada offense. Nevada, they had a big win against Boise State in Boise State, 41-31. Carson Strong, 263 passing and a touchdown. Toa Taua ran for 124 and 2 touchdowns. Defensively, they forced 3 sacks and 3 turnovers in that game. I do think this could be possibly a high-scoring game, but I think Nevada will end up coming out with the victory. So those are my picks for primetime, week 6 of college football. Check out my other picks and my NFL picks later. Peace.